when this investment was being considered. So everybody was saying it is a bailout. We should not throw away good money after bad money. Now if the share price has reached 60 rupees, then also you have a problem that why it is so. So what should have been done? If I can ask you. So I think one, we have to understand that whether it is ICICI Bank or SBI, even SBI, I'm not talking about ICICI, let them decide what they will do. I am also free to sell shares because my compulsion is 26%. But let me assure you, for 3 years, not even a single share will be sold. But that categorical statement, I cannot give on behalf of other banks, but any bank who has invested, everybody is looking at in 3 years' time, we would expect a decent IRR. But none of the banks, and that is precisely the reason that this allocation has been kept for the domestic banks, and to avoid any such, I would say, what should the word I use, allegation?
Controversy.
No, allegation.
But whatever. So that is also, I would say, that is the thinking that one, it should not be seen that anybody is being allowed to do profiteering. And third thing is that let us wait how the price turns out to be. Today's price, we should not read too much because the existing shareholder also there
is. So what is the position with regard to the 81 bonds?
One by one.
Mayur, you had a question?
Yes.
So why should, again, I should ask you that a bank which had difficulty, I'm not against retail shareholders, please. That I must give a caveat. We all are here to protect shareholders' interest, minority shareholders' interest. But in the scheme, the only logic which could be is that everybody should be treated at par on the day of the start of the scheme. When the bank is under PONV Section 45 of RBI Act, so that also means that the equity lost. So equity is not lost. But there is a point that why doesn't everybody start at par? So that is, I think, the only logic which I can understand.